So, Shelley, I mean, one of the, I think, critiques of traditional development policy has been that the international institutions would come in and they would do whatever they thought from their, you know, ivory towers or whatever ought to be done, and there would be no feedback whatsoever, no consultation really with people on the ground, and often as a result it would not actually work. I mean, is technology going to create those feedback loops, bring people in who are the actual supposed beneficiaries of the World Bank's good intentions? And I mean, are we going to see a real transformation in that area?
So it's a great question, because we've had to move way beyond well-intentioned development. I mean, we are very focused on results. There is never enough money. There are always too many good things to do with the pool of money you have, regardless of that pool of money. So you have to move beyond well-intentioned development to results-based development. It's interesting. There's no silver bullet, but we've done things like for our spring meetings and annual meetings, which I think traditionally have been groups of finance ministers and heads of state who convene in Washington or other cities around the world in what are viewed as very closed sessions. We have changed those meetings to be open, web-based, interactive, to take take questions from the field, to have them podcast, to make that available in a much more open and collaborative way. I think we've changed our view of development in terms of thinking development is working solely and only with governments. It is all about partnerships. It is all about the public and the private sectors. It is all about citizens. It is all about a whole ecosystem of knowledge and collaboration working together. So knowledge is a big part of our vocabulary. It's interesting, Steve, when you talked about creating marketplaces, we tend to believe that we are a convener of knowledge. So we have the ability to bring knowledge together in ways that are productive. We want to program in one country and other countries can benefit from it. And what's interesting is this is no longer about the developed world teaching the developing world. There is knowledge, there is innovation, there are insights that are coming from all different directions.
So I mean, it's been interesting to see a site like Ushahidi take off and
Absolutely.
Become a real sort of way of figuring out where pressure points are and so forth. I mean, do you work with sites like that and make use of that information?
We do. We have, we have partnerships, we have outreach in just about every direction, because it's the only productive way to work these days. There's so much more benefit in terms of crowdsourcing. With the earthquake in Haiti, for example, there were all kinds of efforts with crisis camps and random acts of kindness to be able to do geo-mapping, to be able to develop little mobile applications in order to help the aid and recovery process. So a crowdsourcing, a collaborative approach is critical to what we do.